Thank you so much. We are so excited that you're here tonight. We are so excited to finally share with you what we spent much of January working on. For those who may not be familiar with what we do at PLU, in January, we have a January term which lasts about 4 weeks. So these students came back after the holidays on January 2nd and began learning most of the program that we shared when we went out on tour. We left for tour on January 27th. We had performances in Las Vegas, in Oro Valley outside of Tucson, in Mesa outside of Phoenix, in Palm Desert, and then in Thousand Oaks outside of Los Angeles. Along the way, we had exchanges with Northern Arizona University and several high schools. It was a really wonderful trip, about a week or so at the end of January into early February. We came back with some shared illnesses, and that was the reason for postponing the concert a little bit, but we're delighted that everybody is back and ready to share this repertoire with you. You have the programs there. I'll provide a little bit of context as we go through the evening. This next piece is by Mendelssohn. It's his wonderful setting, Richte mich Gott, Psalm 43. And then we'll follow that with a pairing of the same text, Ave Verum Corpus, which is taken from the Feast of Corpus Christi. William Byrd was a composer writing in the Renaissance, spent time writing for both the Catholic Church and the Church of England, right after the time of Henry VIII and the split of the Catholic Church into the Church of England. So the Latin texts were written for Catholic liturgies. His English texts were written for Episcopal liturgies. This one, Ave Verum Corpus, is the Eucharistic text for the Feast of Corpus Christi. And you'll hear many of the hallmarks of Renaissance writing in it, paired voices, imitation, really evocative writing, cross relationships, so F sharps stinging against an F natural in close proximity. And then we follow that with a brand new piece called Ave Verum Corpus Reimagined, which is written by Roderick Williams, which takes the same text and the source material from Byrd and transforms it from a four-part Renaissance motet to a three-choir, 12-part contemporary motet. And you'll hear in it the chords shifting, sometimes simultaneously, sometimes in succession. It's a really cool setting of the piece. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
These next two pieces are about journey. The first is by Sonder Choi, a composer who moved from the Philippines and did his graduate work at USC in California and has made quite a career out of composing out of Los Angeles. The piece, Journey of Your Own, is literally a symbol of his journey from the Philippines to the US. He engaged two of his friends who are poets to write a text, and I invite you to follow along in the program so you hear the interplay of those parts. And then we follow it with a wonderful setting, My Heart Be Brave. All journeys require courage, and this one is a fitting conclusion to the set about journey.
Thank you.
said on tour that that piece was becoming my favorite. That's hard for me to say because I have a piece on the program myself, but it's one of those pieces that I can barely look at them when we're doing it. It's just so beautiful, and it's one of those pieces that I say often, I wish I wrote that. This last piece, before we take a brief intermission just to get off our feet for a few minutes, is called Plaudite Salite. And it is modeled after the compositional technique of Giovanni Gabrieli. If you've been to the Basilica San Marco in Venice, you'll note that the entire cathedral is lined with balconies up top. And composers at the time were like, what if I put a choir there, and a choir there, and a choir there, and a choir there? I've got surround sound. 400 years before we had surround sound, there was Giovanni Gabrieli. And so what we had was what's called cori spezzati, split choirs, where there would be an echo effect. Sometimes the choirs would echo each other and repeat. Sometimes they would sing in imitation. Sometimes they would sing simultaneously. This piece does not involve split choirs, but it does involve some of the same compositional techniques where you'll have lines taking on a principal melodic feel while others are in imitation. And it's not always split between sopranos and altos. It dances around a lot. So a lot of this piece is finding the transparent texture and finding those prominent lines throughout. It's a really cool and engaging piece. Again, right after this, we'll take a brief intermission, about 10 minutes or so, and then we'll be back for the second half.
Thank you.
This next piece is one we just had to take with us on tour. We performed this at our Christmas concert. It's called The Children's Eye. Wonderful setting of text by Caroline Shaw. Caroline was the youngest composer to win the Pulitzer Prize when she wrote her piece Partita for Eight Voices about 12 years ago now. Fantastic composer, really inventive, wonderful harmonic language. This piece utilizes text from Robert Louis Stevenson and the O Antiphons. The O Antiphons are the traditional texts that take us from the first Sunday of Advent through Christmas, through that period of waiting, moving from darkness to light, from despair to hope. And it is that journey that is mirrored in the text of Stevenson. The text itself is speaking of a time, well, he wrote it in the time, but for us, it's a time that we did not have phones, we did not have TVs, we did not have any way to recall the beauty of spring and the rebirth that happens after winter, except for pictures in the storybooks, and that within our own imagination. So we have a storyteller in this who takes us through part of the poetry itself, and the choir comments on it, sometimes repeats that, and then takes on the O Antiphons that bring us through this journey as we move through this time of darkness into rebirth and warmth. Our soloist this evening is Caitlin.
Thank you.
I mentioned that this was part of our J term, and so each day the choir came together at 9:30 in the morning, and basically the outside times for our rehearsals were 9:30 to 4 o'clock. And it was the only class the students were taking during January. It was fantastic. Choir all the time. I loved it. But things happened quickly in J term, and we learned the program and worked on it for about 2 weeks before we take it out on the road. So long story short, we have a bonus track for you that will go in to make a set with this next piece. We'll start this next set with The Road Home, Stephen Paulus's beautiful work. I won't say much about it, I'll let you experience it. And then we'll follow it with the title track of our program, The Gift to Sing. You may have noticed that My Heart Be Brave was also a poem by James Weldon Johnson. These are really evocative texts, and Damian Jeter has done such a wonderful job in setting this. And it is about finding the hopefulness, finding the joy, and using this grand magic we have, that is the gift to sing, to overcome the darkness and overcome the mist. Our soloist in The Road Home is Hannah McVeigh.
Thank you.
These next two pieces are indicated in your program as a set. If we do our job, I think you'll want to applaud after the first one, so feel free to do so. Don't feel like you have to wait. The first is a wonderful setting by Nilo Akala, of a children's game, highly rhythmic, lots of fun. And the second is a call to a dance. Enjoy.